And Sung Jin-cho met up with our colleagues at WCRB in Boston for an interview about this piece, which he played with the Boston Symphony just a few days ago. This is what he said about the Ravel.
I've been always loving this concerto since many years, and I always wanted to include this concerto in my repertoire, and I'm really glad that I'm finally be able to play this piece. And this piece is very different from the G major concerto, and I feel like this piece is more jazzy and has lots of character in the middle section. It sounds like military march a little bit, because Ravel composed this piece for Paul Wittgenstein, who lost his right arm during the war. And I feel like in this piece you can hear some tragedy and also like a military march, but you know, there's some kind of spirit in the piece, and I'm always imagining about the war and tragedy, and like sometimes also very depressing.
Song Jin-cho talking about the piano concerto for the left hand that we're about to hear in this performance from Carnegie Hall. So that's some of the imagery behind the work, but we also talked to Song Jin-cho about the actual difficulty of just playing the piece.
Even though technically it's so demanding, and I've never played a piece only for the left hand before, I think the music itself is so beautiful and wonderful. So when I play this piece, I stop thinking about that I'm playing only my left hand. But of course, it's so difficult, especially the cadenzas. They're so difficult, and it's so tempting because I want to use my right hand also.
All right, well, they'll have to tie Sung Jin-cho's right hand behind his back, I guess, to avoid the temptation of using both hands. I have to say, Jeff, that as with several of the pieces that Wittgenstein composed, you would never know, unless you were a pianist yourself, that you were listening to a pianist playing with just one hand.
Oh, it's extraordinary what such artists are able to do. They really are quite amazing.
And I wish I could say there is a happy ending to the story of Ravel and Wittgenstein, but Wittgenstein, when he premiered the piece, made some changes to the score that Ravel did not appreciate, and the two had a falling out and never reconciled.
Right, so an interesting story about a great contribution to the piano literature, but which destroyed a friendship in the process. By the way, we should also say thanks to our colleagues at WCRB in Boston and producer Brian McCreath for that interview with Song Jin-cho that we were able to share with you tonight.